Hello, MPWF fan base, and welcome to MPWF Smackdown Episode 9. We are here live from Seattle, Washington. We kick things off with the MPWF chairman, as the MPWF chairman wants to make his way to the ring, as he has something to say. This past week on MPWF Raw, we saw the return of the MPWF chairman. It has been years since the chairman has been here in the MPWF, but once we heard Remedy by Siva, we knew who it was. The MPWF chairman came and he made his impact. He made a statement when he returned. He has released Vern Mungo from his general manager duties here in the MPWF. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. Vern Mungo is no longer the general manager of MPWF Raw or SmackDown. And ladies and gentlemen, the MPWF chairman wants to speak. And thank God that the cabinet's reign of terror is over thanks to the MPWF chairman. It's a good thing nobody wants to see WrestleMania ruin whatsoever. And that is true, ladies and gentlemen. At WrestleMania, it will be Mr. Vern Mungo versus MVP in a one-on-one contest. If Vern Mungo still wants a job here in the MPWF, he must defeat MVP, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, Vern Mungo is going to be actioning tonight. Who's he going to be up against tonight? Who's he going to be competing against tonight on SmackDown? It's going to be the main event. Big matchup. Oh my God! The MPWF chairman is putting him in a Vern Mungo in a matchup against Apollo. He's reinstating the protector, the Apollo, back here in the MPWF. Will he be here? But hang on a sec. There's Yamasaki Yoshino making his way to the ring. We saw his sick ass actions on MPWF Raw Episode 9. Yamasaki Yoshino, you can see he's not happy whatsoever about anything that's gone down here. The cabinet at losing all their power in the MPWF. You see the tension here between the chairman and Yoshino. They think they built a dynasty. What a joke. Well, people, if you think these are the reason, the cabinet's the reason to watch the MPWF, then you're living a sad life. These guys are sick bastards, and certainly not the reason the majority of the fans are watching this show at all. And now, Yoshino there with his idle threats. Oh my God. There's no way to talk to your boss, Yoshino. The hell? Oh my God, Craig David out of nowhere! Where did Craig David come from? Craig David, his opponent at WrestleMania, got inside the ring and just super kicked Yamasaki Yoshino right in the face. Craig David out of nowhere with a super kick. Absolutely knocking Yoshino out. Now the chairman celebrating with his WrestleMania opponent and the Royal Rumble winner. And ladies and gentlemen, this is the MPWF Car Contest. If you cannot read the screen at this time, pause the screen to read it. But ladies and gentlemen, it's now time to have your car in the MPWF. If you have an Xbox 360, or you have if you know someone who can create your car in the Xbox, have them upload your car to Community Creations and tag it or put the keyword as the MPWF Car Contest. DJ Johnny Fielgen, OG Local, to choose the top three cars and they will make an appearance at WrestleMania, and then the winner will be chosen on the first edition of MPWF War. Ladies and gentlemen, make your cars as realistic as possible. They can either be male or female. It's time to have your car here in the MPWF, ladies and gentlemen. Good luck on this car contest. And here we are backstage with an irate Yamasaki Yoshino getting in the face of the tag team champions. Did Yamasaki Yoshino just call the Gothic Society pasty idiots? Well, Yoshino is pissed off beyond belief. He is frustrated. I mean, he came out here to intimidate the MPWF chairman and ended up getting a super kick in the face for his troubles. I mean, now he's saying the natural disasters aren't doing their job. Well, anyways, it's crazy here in the MPWF, but up next, ladies and gentlemen, is a Cruiserweight Championship matchup. White Boy Fresh looks to try and regain back his Cruiserweight title after losing to El Negro on MPWF Episode 9 of Raw, the tribute to the troops. Like I said, both these Army boys, Army brats, if you will, battled it out at the Tribute to the Troops show, and unfortunately for White Boy Fresh, he lost to El Negro and lost his coveted Cruiserweight Championship. And White Boy Fresh wants that Cruiserweight Championship bat. That is his baby, and he needs it. We wanted to get some interview time back with White Boy Fresh, but he wasn't available. He has been training, preparing for this contest. He wants that belt more than anything else in the world. He loves being the Cruiserweight Champion, and so does this man, El Negro, who we did get to speak with. El Negro has yet to speak for this partner, Kid Mysterio, as Kid Mysterio is not here on SmackDown in Seattle, Washington tonight. He's still in Spokane, Washington. So El Negro, he really wants to talk to his partner about winning this Cruiserweight Championship. Now both of them have held the Cruiserweight title. So El Negro won his first ever singles championship and his first ever opportunity at the singles championship. And so the crowd in Baghdad, Iraq loved El Negro, and the same thing here tonight in Seattle. I said these guys had a very athletic contest, and it was a great battle between the two, and we expect to see the same thing here tonight on SmackDown. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, I'd like to tell you that MPWF SmackDown Episode 9 is sponsored by SmackDown vs. Raw 2011. This is your moment, and it is also sponsored by Left 4 Dead. It's one badass game. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen, the Cruiserweight Championship on the line, and that's what this matchup is all about. And you can see our referee holding up the belt, ladies and gentlemen. And as we set forth, get ready for this contest. And confidence is a stain they can't wipe off. My word is my pride, but wisdom is bleak, and that's it. And here we go, Cruiserweight action for the evening. First contest every episode of SmackDown, and now White Boy Fresh now going for a power slam. And White Boy Fresh is probably going to change his game plan a bit. White Boy Fresh is going to try and ground El Negro, as White Boy Fresh probably believed he'd be quicker than El Negro and found out that he wasn't on Raw. And you can see here, more brawling, White Boy Fresh changing it up a bit, changing up his style to surprise the Cruiserweight Champion. And oh my god, high blowing body press to the outside of the ring by White Boy Fresh. Cruiserweight action at its finest. And White Boy Fresh now staying on top of El Negro and telling the fans that it's all good. Now White Boy Fresh attacking El Negro, and El Negro there. Look at the speed of El Negro, and now the atomic drop there on White Boy Fresh. And El Negro with a shoulder block takedown on Fresh. And El Negro heading to the outside of the ring. And we could be seeing El Negro looking to dive off the ropes. No, never mind, gets back outside. And now a neck breaker on the outside of the ring, taking down White Boy Fresh. El Negro back inside the ring again. And El Negro watching on. And El Negro telling White Boy Fresh to get back inside the ring. And now you can see El Negro with those big punches, and what a drop kick there by El Negro. Negro going for the cover here. And we always talk about how El Negro has lost a ton of weight since coming from SmackDown vs. Raw 2010. Said that we saw it help him greatly in his matchup on Raw. We talked about the speed of El Negro has increased so much, and White Boy Fresh moving out the way. And don't discount White Boy Fresh's speed. This man is super quick in the ring. What a power slam there by White Boy Fresh. Now Fresh heading to the top rope. Fresh off the top, driving the fist in the face. It's like a modified five knuckle shuffle there by White Boy Fresh. And now Fresh with an elbow into the head of El Negro. Now picking him back up. And now White Boy Fresh now going for the Irish whip. But ladies and gentlemen, it's time for a break. When we return, you'll see more of MPWF SmackDown action.